started. So in our previous Quran learning series module, we discussed the verses 89 and 90 of Surah Al Baqarah. Verse number 89. فَلَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ كِتَابٌ مِّنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ مُصَدِّقٌ لِمَا مَعَهُمْ
كِتَابٌ مِّنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا مَعَهُمْ وَكَانُوا مِن قَبْلُ يَسْتَفْتِحُونَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا
فلما جاءهم كتاب من عند الله مصدقا لما بين بما معهم وكانوا من قبل يستفتحون على الذين كفروا فلما جاءهم ما عرفوا كفروا به
فلعنة الله على الكافرين.
لما جاءهم كتاب من عند الله مصدقا لما معهم. And when there came to them,
that is the Jews, the book that is this Quran.
Yes. مصدقا لما معهم. That is this Quran from Allah. لما جاءهم كتاب من عند الله from Allah confirming
what is with them.
Yes. Allowed.
What is with them, that is Taurat and Injil.
Yes.
Although a fourth time,
that is before. They had invoked Allah.
That is
for the coming of
Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In order to gain victory over
those who disbelieved.
When they disbelieved in him.
Yes.
So let the curse of Allah be
on the disbelievers. Verse 90.
أن يكفروا بما أنزل الله من عباده فباءوا بغضب على غضب وللكافرين عذاب مهين. How bad is that which they have Allah?
How bad is that for which they have sold their own selves?
That they should disbelieve in that which Allah has revealed to them.
That is the Quran.
Grudging that Allah has revealed of His days.
Allah revealed His days unto whom
He wills of His servants.
So they have drawn on themselves. غضبٍ على غضب.
Oh, they have drawn up themselves.
Wrath upon wrath. Ghadabun ala ghadab. Then, and for the disbelievers.
For the disbelievers, there is distressing torment.
Yes, you haven't studied. So, a brief description of these verses. Explanation. Thank you.
Here Allah mentions the policy of the Jews.
Yes. What was their policy? This. They denied.
Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Although there.
Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Holy Quran. Then. Although they had aforetime used to invoke
the Allah.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For the coming of this Prophet. And to aid them. In order to aid them by his arrival against their polytheistic enemies.
Then,
yes.
Although the advent of final messenger
Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam
was foretold
in their scriptures. Then, even then they disbelieved in him. Yes.
When Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came from Arabs.
From the Arabs, yes.
Just because he came from the Arabs,
He came, that is Prophet, the final Prophet, final messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came from the Arabs and not from the Israelites. So that's why they denied the Prophet and the final scripture. Which was brought to him. What was that is some of the Sahabas that is Mu'adh bin Jabal, Bishr bin Bara'u, bin Ma'rur, Dawood bin Salama. These Sahaba asked the Yahudis, the Jews, the Israelites, that why they are not accepting or embracing Islam. They are not approving Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a prophet and as the last and final messenger. Because they were invoking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the coming of this prophet. And they were saying that, we will defeat you, you polytheist. These Sahaba were Ahl Shirk during that time. Then the Jews told them, we will get a messenger in our book. There is prophesied the advent of a prophet, and with the help of that prophet, we will defeat you, polytheists. Then they asked, the Sahaba asked, why then, after the coming of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you are rejecting him, you are not accepting him, why it is so? Then Salam bin Mishkam said, what? This Salam bin Mishkam of Banu Nadir of the Jews, one tribe among the Jews, Banu Nadir, and one member of that tribe, Salam bin Mishkam, a Jew, replied. What was his reply? Ma ja'ana bi shay'in ya'rifu, wa ma huwa bil ladhi kunna nadhkuru lakum. Meaning,
he said he did not bring anything that we recognize.
And he is not the prophet that we were talking to you, talking about. Okay. Now, next verse. Verses 91, 92 and 93 of Surah Al-Baqarah. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم ربي أعوذ بك من همزات الشياطين وأعوذ بك ربي أن يحضرون. ولقد جاءكم موسى بالبينات ثم اتخذتم العجل من بعده وأنتم ظالمون. فإذا قيل لهم آمنوا بما أنزل الله قالوا نؤمن بما أنزل علينا ويكفرون بما وراءه وهو الحق مصدقا لما معهم قل فلم تقتلون أنبياء الله من قبل إن كنتم مؤمنين. ولقد جاءكم موسى بالبينات ثم اتخذتم العجل من بعده وأنتم ظالمون. وإذ أخذنا ميثاقكم ورفعنا فوقكم الطور خذوا ما آتيناكم بقوة واسمعوا قالوا سمعنا وعصينا وأشربوا في قلوبهم العجل بكفرهم قل بئس ما يأمركم به إيمانكم إن كنتم مؤمنين. وإذا قيل لهم آمنوا and when it is said to them, it is to the Jews, بما آمنوا, you believe, بما أنزل الله, that is, in what Allah has revealed, that is the Holy Quran, the final scripture of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قالوا, they will say, نؤمن بما أنزل علينا ويكفرون بما وراء. نؤمن بما أنزل علينا. We will believe in what is revealed to us. What is revealed to us? That is, what was revealed to them? Torah. And ويكفرون بما وراء. And they disbelieve in which came after it. Came behind it. Came after that. That is, what was the revealed, which scripture was revealed after Torah and Injil? Torah and Injil, after Torah and Injil, Al Quran, yes. وَهُوَ الْحَقُّ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا مَعَهُمْ. While it is the truth confirming what is with them. So this Quran confirms the essence of the messages contained in Torah and Injil. Still, they were not ready to accept this message, the Quran. And they denied Prophet Muhammad. Well, then you ask, O Muhammad, لِفَلِّمَ تَقْتُلُونَ أَنْبِيَاءَ اللَّهِ مِنْ قَبْلِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. And if you are believing, if you are believers, then why did you kill? Why are you killing? Or why did you kill the prophets from amongst themselves? That is, from amongst the Israelites themselves. After the advent of Prophet Musa alayhi salam, there came a series of messengers from among the Israelites. But many of them were killed by Israelites themselves, by the Jews themselves. Jews killed so many prophets. Okay, so if you believe in Torah, that is the scripture which was revealed to you, then if you are truthful to that, then why did you kill the prophets from amongst themselves who preached Torah, preached and practiced Torah? Okay. So you are telling lies. Not only that, if they believed actually in Torah, they must follow the messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because the advent or the coming of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is mentioned or foretold, prophesied here, where? In the scripture of Torah, the Torah, the advent of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was mentioned or foretold, prophesied. Okay. وَلَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ مُوسَى بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ ثُمَّ اتَّخَذْتُمُ الْعِجْلَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ وَأَنْتُمْ ظَالِمُونَ. And indeed, Musa came to you with clear proofs, yet you worshipped the calf after death. He left and you were transgressors. So, وَلَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ مُوسَىٰ بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ. And Musa came to you with clear signs. With clear signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ثُمَّ تَخْفُتُمُ الْعِجِّلَةِ. So, even that, after that, yet you اتَّخْفُتُمُ الْعِجِّلَةِ. You worshipped the calf. مِنْ بَعْدِهِ. After he left. After he left to receive the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To have a munajat with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then at that time they worshipped what? They worshipped the calf. Yes. وَأَنْتُمْ ظَالِمُونَ. And you were ظَالِمُونَ. You were transgressors. You did ظُلْم. Okay. Then. Next verse. وَإِذْ أَخَذْنَا مِيثَاقَكُمْ وَرَفَعْنَا فَوْقَكُمُ الطُّورَ خُذُوا مَا آتَيْنَاكُمْ بِقُوَّةٍ خُذُوا مَا آتَيْنَاكُمْ بِقُوَّةٍ وَاسْمَعُوا قَالُوا سَمِعْنَا وَعَصَيْنَا وَأُشْرِبُوا فِي قُلُوبِهِمُ الْعِجْلَ بِكُفْرِهِمْ قُلْ بِئْسَ مَا يَأْمُرُكُمْ بِهِ إِيمَانُكُمْ إِن كُنتُم مُّؤْمِنِينَ. And remember when we took your covenant, when we raised and when we raised above you the mount Tur, saying, but Hulu ma ataynakum biquwwa. So Allah took a covenant from the Israelites by rising the Tur's, mount Tur, above them, rising Mount Tur above them. What did Allah say? What did Allah take as covenant? خُذُوا مَا آتَيْنَاكُمْ بِقُوَّةٍ. Hold firmly to what we have given to you. Hold firmly to what we have given to you. خُذُوا. خُذُوا. Okay. Catch. Hold. Pidichu. Muritke pidika. وَاسْمَعُوا. And you hear. You hear. And you hear the message. Then what did they say? قَالُوا سَمِعُنَا وَعَصْوَيْنَا. Yes, we have heard and we have disobeyed. We have heard, simply. What is the meaning of it? Say it. We have heard, simply we have heard. And وَعَصْوَيْنَا. And we have disobeyed. We have heard with our ears. Okay, then. وَأُشْرِبُ فِي قُلُوبِهِمُ الْعِجْلَ بِكُفْرِهِمْ. And their hearts absorbed the worship of the calf because of their disbelief, because of their kufriyat. Okay, so the love for the calf was absorbed into their hearts, Okay. قُلْ بِئْسَ مَا يَأْمُرُكُمْ بِهِ إِيمَانُكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. قُلْ, O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, worst indeed is that which your faith enjoins on you if you are believers. If you are believers, what the faith commands you, what your faith or your belief asks you to do like this. If you are believers, will you do like this? Killing prophets? Like this? Okay. Then. So, if you are true believers in the scripture of Torah, you will never kill your prophets. Also, you will believe in the last and final messenger. Because it is foretold. His coming is foretold in your scripture, it is the Torah. Then, no. So Allah tells here the nature of the Jews, that when they were told to believe in the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the final scripture, the Holy Quran revealed to him. They told that they will believe in the Torah only, which was revealed to them. and will not believe in the Quran and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, though the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to them confirming what was with them. It is the essence of the previous scriptures, the Torah and the Injil. Then Allah tells Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to ask them if they believed in Torah, then why they had killed the previous prophets from amongst the Israelites themselves. Why did they kill their own prophets then? So this means that since what was sent to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam conforms to what was revealed to the people of the book, and they knew the arrival of the prophets. So the arrival of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was known to them. It was known to them. But it was not known to the Quraysh or the Arabs. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came from the Arabs. It's okay. But they didn't knew it actually. Earlier, they had no knowledge of the coming of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because they had no Vedas, they had no scriptures, they were not Ahlul Kitab. But the Jews were not like that. The Jews and Christians, or Ahlul Kitab, Ahlul Injil, Ahlul Torah, they were not like that. They knew that there will come a prophet. But then, actually they knew the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that the Messenger is Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Prophet Muhammad was the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They knew the truth, but yet they denied. So this fact is described, mentioned in another verse in Surah Al Baqarah itself, verse number 146. الذين آتيناهم الكتاب يعرفونه كما يعرفون أبناءهم وإن فريقا منهم ليكتمون الحق وهم يعلمون. Those to whom we gave the scripture, that is the Jews and Christians, or Ahlul Kitab, Ahlul Torah and Ahlul Injil, they recognized him, that is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They knew him, they knew that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is actually a prophet of Allah, messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as they recognized their sons. Will they recognize their sons? A father will recognize his son. Will they recognize their sons, the Jews? So just like that, they knew the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Just like they knew their own sons. They knew their own sons. Okay. Like that, they knew Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That means they knew Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam actually. Then, really. So the qualities of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which were written in Torah and Injil, that they knew. The sifat of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that is the would-be prophet. It was foretold, or the prophet was foretold in their scripture. Then Allah said, next, فَلِمَا تَقْتُلُونَ أَنْبِيَاءَ اللَّهِ مِنْ قَبْلِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Why then you have killed the prophets of Allah aforetime, and if you indeed have been believers? If you are believers, then why did you kill the prophets from amongst you? So this means, if you claim that you believe in what was revealed to you is true, then why did you kill the prophets of Allah who came to you affirming the Torah law? Although you knew they were true prophets, you killed them simply out of transgression, stubbornness and injustice with Allah's messengers. Therefore, you only follow your lusts, your opinions, your desires. So you are simply for your hawa. What is befitting to your jasad, your body? What is befitting, what is suitable for your lust? Whenever there comes to them a prophet which is against their will, with messages which are against their wills, their own wills, or their own hawa, their own lust, their own desires, then what will they do? We have seen it earlier in verse 87 of Surah Al Baqarah. أَفَكُلَّمَا جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ بِمَا لَا تَهْوَى أَنفُسُكُمْ اسْتَكْبَرْتُمْ فَفَرِيقًا كَذَّبْتُمْ وَفَرِيقًا تَقْتُلُونَ فَفَرِيقًا كَذَّبْتُمْ وَفَرِيقًا تَقْتُلُونَ. Is it that whenever there came to you a messenger with what you yourselves desired not, you grew arrogant, استكبرتم. Some you disbelieved and some you killed. No. Next verse. وَلَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ مُوسَى بِالْبَيْنَاتِ. And indeed Musa came to you with clear signs, with clear proofs. Meaning, with clear signs, with clear proofs that he was the messenger of Allah and that there is no deity worth your worship except Allah. So such bayinat were given to them. This Musa alayhi salam is the prophet of Allah. And he had came with the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that, la ilaha illallah, there is no deity worth your worship except Allah. So, la ilaha illallah was the message of all the prophets to all mankind. Okay, what was that? Tawheed is la ilaha illallah. There is no deity worthy of worship except Allah. Okay, then there is no ilah except Allah. La ilaha illallah. The clear signs or miracles mentioned here, the flood, the locust, the lice, frogs, blood, staff, and the hand. So all these were the miracles shown to them by Prophet Muhammad, Prophet Musa alayhi salam. You know, then the flood, the locust, then the lice, and the frogs, blah, blah, blah. Then you see, then the blood, the staff, the stick or staff of Musa alayhi salam, which turned into what? No, when the stick is put under the ground, on the ground, it will turn into what? Turn into a? Yes. Say aloud.
Snake,
a serpent. Okay. Then also, what you told is correct. With that stick, when he beat or strike the stone, there came how many springs? 12 springs. Then also, when they were escaping from the tyranny, from the tyrannies of Pharaoh, they reached the Nile or reached the sea. Then what did Musa alayhi salam do upon the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He tried the sea. Then it is divided. There a clear path was shown for them to escape. They escaped and thrown, and his followers followed them, but they were drowned. So all these miracles they have seen with their own eyes. Okay? Miracles, all these miracles. Still, also the shading with the clouds. In the hot deserts, they were given shade, special shade by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, they were given special type of food. Which were they?
Manna
and salwa. Yes. So, but also, after Prophet Musa alayhi salam went to Thor to receive the commandments or to speak to Allah, they worshipped the calf. That is mentioned in another verse. وَاتَّخَذَ قَوْمُ مُوسَى مِنْ بَعْدِهِ مِنْ حُلِيِّهِمْ عُجْدِلًا جَسَدًا لَهُ خُوَارٌ أَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّهُ لَا يُكَلِّمُهُمْ وَلَا يُهْدِيهِمْ سَبِيلًا اتَّخَذُوهُ وَكَانُوا ظَالِمِينَ فَلَمَّا سُقِطَ فِي أَيْدِيهِمْ وَرَأُوا أَنَّهُمْ قَدْ ضَلُّوا قَالُوا لَئِن لَّمْ يَرْحَمْنَا رَبُّنَا فَيَغْفِرْ لَنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. And the people of Moses, Musa alayhi salam, made in his absence out of their ornaments, their gold ornaments, the image of or the form of a calf for worship. Then it had a sound also. Just as a lehu khuwa. It made a sound. Mukra. A sound in there. Then did they not see that it could neither speak to them nor guide them. The way they took it. To the way. So they actually knew that this calf is something made by their own hands, with the ornaments, with their own ornaments. Then this calf, which they were worshipping, can't help them. Okay, can speak to them, can hear them. Still they worshipped the calf. When Musa was away from them. Then. And when they regretted, they saw that they had gone astray. They said, if our Lord have not mercy upon us and forgive us, we shall certainly be of the losers. So all this Allah forgive for them. Still, they rebelled against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They rebelled against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then after the advent of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they were not ready to accept Islam, accept the message of Quran. Then this their rebellious nature of the Jews mentioned here. قَالُوا سَمِعْنَا وَعَصَيْنَا. We have heard. Simply we have heard. وَعَصَيْنَا. And we disbelieved. So this a rebellious nature. Rebellious nature and proud. It's arrogance of Jews. Arrogant nature of the Jews revealed. That وَوُشْتِبُ فِي قُلُوبِهِمُ الْعِجْلَ بِكُفْرِهِمْ. And their hearts absorb the worship of the calf. That means the love for the calf was absorbed into their hearts. Okay. They were mad with that love. In one hadith, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the love for the calf, what happens when one is mad with love? Sometimes it may be to a person, to the opposite sex, or to a material thing, like that. Then, even if one is mad with love or craziness, we say craziness in English, the craziness, extreme love, mad with love, then see Allah's Messenger says, what will happen for them, for such a people, for such a man? حُبُّكَ الشَّيْءِ يُعْمِي وَيُسْلِمْ. That means your love or craziness for a thing will make you blind and deaf. Okay? Will make you blind and deaf. Then, if you love a thing or a person so much, extreme love, craziness, then you will be blind actually. You can't see only him or her or that. Okay? Then, so your love or craziness for a thing will make you blind and deaf. Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum.